Let's look at the next sets of provisions, aggregator and e-commerce. So, can you read out the
list? Aggregator. Aggregator means a person who owns and manages an electronic platform and by means of the application and a communication device enables a potential customer to connect with the person providing service of a particular kind under a brand name or trade name of the said aggregator.
So typically we are trying to look at situations of Ola cabs and Meru cabs where they have an online platform or an app which enables the taxi driver to connect with you. Of course, there has been a litigation in the service tax and somewhere we just felt that we want to have tax on everything, so we just keep on complicating things. So we brought in this concept of aggregator. Also read the e-commerce and the e-commerce operator. Electronic commerce definition D.
Electronic commerce shall mean the supply or receipt of goods and or services or transmitting of funds or data over an electronic network, primarily the internet, by using any applications that rely on the internet, but not limited to email, instant messaging, shopping carts, web services, universal description, discovery and integration, file transfer protocol, and electronic data interchange, whether or not payment is conducted online, and whether or not the ultimate delivery of the goods and or services is done by the operator. Electronic commerce operator shall include every person.
Why? Please each of you read this last electronic commerce operator. It's not just the Amazons of the world. Read it well and maybe you will find many surprises. Yeah.
Electronic commerce operator shall include every person who directly or indirectly owns, operates or manages an electronic platform that is engaged in facilitating the supply of any goods and or services or in providing any information or any other service incidental to or in connection therewith, but shall not include persons engaged in supply of such goods and or services on their own behalf.
So we have a situation of two different sets of provisions we are talking about here, and all of these definitions have been just interchangeably used in various places. But conceptually, there is a fundamental difference between the way an aggregator would be paying GST as compared to an e-commerce operator. What we are told is, as far as the aggregator is concerned, the service shall be defined to have been rendered by the aggregator himself. So the taxi driver will not pay the tax. Instead of that, Meru, which is the aggregator, or Ola, which is the aggregator, will pay the tax on behalf of this person. So the other person need not take registration at all. This person will discharge all the tax liabilities. That is as far as aggregator is concerned. But e-commerce doesn't work that way. E-commerce can here be brought in a TCS concept. And because the thought process is that in e-commerce, the underlying supplier will also have accumulated credits. Because you will be procuring goods and services. And therefore here, there's a concept of TCS. The rate of TCS will be prescribed. So e-commerce operator will pay that much TCS. And he will give the credit of that TCS to the underlying supplier. So it's more like a TDS concept, a variation of a TDS concept, which is coming in an e-commerce operator. Now the way e-commerce operators worded, many online platforms may get covered into it. You might have commodity exchanges, you might face a difficulty, you might have stock exchanges, and many agencies can perhaps fit within the way the e-commerce is defined. It may not be restricted only to the eBays and the Amazons of the world. So that is where the concern would come, and then it would be an onerous obligation on the part of so many different types of people to comply with all these provisions which have been mentioned here. So let's see the TCS part.
Section 43C1 talks about collection of tax at source. Notwithstanding anything to the contrary contained in the Act or in any contract, agreement or memorandum of understanding, every electronic commerce operator, herein after referred to as the operator, shall at the time of credit of any amount to the account of the supplier of goods and or services, or at the time of payment of any amount in cash or by any other mode, whichever is earlier, collect an amount out of the amount payable or paid to the supplier, representing considerations towards the supplier of goods and or services made through it, calculated at such rate as may be notified in this behalf by the central state government on the recommendation of the council.
So this is what we are talking about. TCS is an on-account payment. There's an elaborate mechanism. There's a separate filing of return which will ultimately go to the underlying supplier. So just like we have ITC flowing from one account to another, here you will have a TCS flowing from one account to another. Same way, there's a concept of TDS which will also flow, which is not covered here, but it's separately covered in the next slide. So you have so many different flows of information and obligations which are coming in. So we'll just try to put a small comparison of those areas. And when you look at the comparison, there are different sections dealing with each of them. And as I told you, the liability to pay tax is different. As far as aggregator is concerned, the entire liability is shifted to the aggregator. But when you look at e-commerce and TDS, it's not that way. You are actually having a liability to pay, but it's only the part of that tax which is TDS or TCS at the other end. And the rate of tax again in the first and the third case, aggregator and RCA will be the full rate, whereas in e-commerce and TDS there will be a lower rate which will be defined. So that is what again will come into place. Concerns will be if you have both, then you have a problem of donations. And even right now in the service tax regime, we have seen that officers are very aggressive and they want to link donations to some specific supplier.